welcome to a new Broodling Bulletins edition, number 6, believe it or not. And it's been a year since I put one up. Anyway, welcome and stuff, and just want to say a few things and see where everything takes me as far as rambling and stuff. As far as the channel, coming up on 3,000 subscribers. So, I'm going to put out another video regarding that. And I have a couple post-its of things to say. Mass Effect 2, I am in the middle of that, loving it extremely. And thanks everybody for watching. The spoilers have pretty much faded away, thankfully, at least for now. So things are good. And of course, I'll be playing Mass Effect 3 afterwards. Every once in a while someone asks me that, and yes, I've played 1 and 2, and you know, I'm not going to be fed up and not play 3. And I'm also playing Star Trek, The Next Generation of Final Unity, which is the third Star Trek game. I started out with the 25th anniversary, which is kind of ironic because it just happens to be the 50th anniversary of Star Trek this year. And after that, I played Judgment Rights. And that was the original Trek. And those were released by Interplay in, I believe, 91 and then in 93 for PC DOS. And those were a lot of fun adventure games. Yay! And Star Trek TNG Final Unity is the same. We're in 95 now as far as that game, so we're a little further along. Still, original crew voices and everything. It's pretty awesome. So I'm kind of in the beginning of that, and after I'm done with that, I will be playing the Genesis Mega Drive game, which is Star Trek TNG Echoes from the Past. And then I'll be done. Then I'll be done with the Star Trek stuff, so... No Man's Sky. Yes. I'm uploading No Man's Sky. I'm mostly keeping to a every other day upload, as far as that. I'm having a lot of trouble recording. Frame skips, audio, video, desync, just, it's insane. So because of that, and because of the random nature of it, I mean, the first batch of episodes I did, basically, dump, there you are. With a lot of editing, though. I really had to match up the audio to the video and all that fun kind of fun stuff and not fun stuff. And I had to cut it off at certain points and it was horrible. And my voice is very hoarse, so if you guys hear my voice being deeper than usual, I don't know what it is. I'm just a little hoarse. I have been speaking a lot. I don't feel like I have a cold or anything. It's just, it sometimes happens. So that's that. So No Man's Sky, I'm going to continue. They're adding things. I know all the controversy with the game. They're adding things in now. Some things I believe that they've stated would be in the game at launch, or at least alluded to it. So that's why some people are not very happy. And plus, the game was really overhyped by the general public, or the gaming circles anyway. So it was hyped to the point where, well, no game can do all this. You know, and some people were really like, I want to do multiplayer. I want to do multiplayer. And he was like, it's very hard to do multiplayer. You might not find anybody. It's very difficult. And he didn't really come out and say, though, there's no multiplayer. But really, from everything he said, you shouldn't have bought the game if you wanted multiplayer. That's just me. But then again, I did a lot of research, watched a lot of videos before they came out, and I just happened to know that It is listed as a feature, so if you didn't really know any better, then I guess you got trapped by that. I'm looking forward to the things they're going to add. I'm still having problems with frame skipping now when I go into structures. Everything bugs out, and I end up looking down on the ground away from the door that I was trying to go in. And it's a little ridiculous and annoying, but there's two things they're going to be adding that improve the frame rates. I wonder if I can find it, actually. As far as I know, this is new. Synchronize frame capping with the first V-Sync, which resolves some frame rate issues. I don't know, I swear I had seen something else related to performance, and I can't find it now. The other issue is that I have a mouse with, it's, I don't know if you can see it. It's a scroll wheel, and it's a button. This works as a middle mouse button. I don't know if it's a problem with all the mouse scroll wheels, but I can't, it won't work in the game. And that's to drop an item. For some strange reason, middle mouse button drops an item, and that's one of a couple controls that for some reason you can't change the key binding on. At least, my phone, at least the last time I saw. So I ended up using a program called Neat Mouse to map the middle mouse button to a button on my keyboard. The only problem is that I don't know if there's a conflict between Neat Mouse and No Man's Sky, because after a while playing No Man's Sky, it just stops working. And it won't work again until I quit out, close Neat Mouse, and then reopen. So there's that. I hope they, you know, let us remap that key. It's really simple. There's a whole bunch of other remappings, but for some reason, dropping an item, and I believe, I'm not sure, but renaming a planet and uploading a planet without renaming, you can't change those from X to whatever. Weird. It is weird. So, other than that, it's great. I had a friend try it, and she was like, I'm going to steal my brother's PlayStation 4, and get the game. So, the thing is Batman. Yeah, I uploaded the first episode, the first Telltale episode, which is five of my videos of Batman. If you were on Patreon, or if you are, well, yeah, if you were at that time on Patreon, you got access to the videos 10 days early. Now, what it is I was in the middle of Star Trek Judgment Rites, and I figured at the end of Star Trek Judgment Rites, I would put up the Batman series. But I had it done already, and I had 10 episodes left. So I dumped them on Patreon, and my two Patreon supporters, Sam White and Meerkats United, thanks guys so much, they got to see it early. So I'm going to be putting up a few other videos. Actually, this vlog is going to be up a couple days early before I put it on, you know, make it public. So there's that. And thinking of bringing back the Chick Bits videos, little clips of gaming goodness and stuff, usually comedic in some way. So I'll be putting those up first. Now, I think what I can do, I'm not sure if it works that way, because with the Batman, I put up two separate videos. I put up an unlisted and a scheduled. So the schedule released on that day, and the unlisted was for the, you know, the Patreon people. I think what I can do is just put it unlisted and then change it to public. And I thought that people wouldn't be notified if you did that. Like, people wouldn't know unless they went to my channel or, you know, happened to search, do a YouTube search, then they'd find it. But I think you do get notified now. They might have changed that. Either that or I had a different understanding than what was reality. So Obviously, yeah, I'll be playing the other episodes as soon as they come out, and I'll probably just put them, you know, in the middle and just pause whatever LP I'm doing. Because, I don't know, I really wanted to get through the Star Trek. I wanted to finish it. So, and I figured that would be a good way to, you know, thank my Patreon supporters. If anyone's interested in donating to the Patreon, Patreon, it's, the link is down below in the description with all the other social media links. It's also on my channel on top. I think you have to be on PC to see that, though. So, coming, yeah, Enderal. I don't know where I'm going to fit that. For some reason, I had this funny idea of alternating Enderal and No Man's Sky. I mean, maybe. But then I'm playing four games simultaneously. And Enderal's a lot longer than I thought it was going to be. Apparently, it's 100 hours. Approximately. And the way I play games will probably end up being like 120 or something. On top of that. So, I don't know where I'm going to fit it, because No Man's Sky is going to go on for a long time. Once the Star Trek games are done, I want to get caught up with the King's Quest, the new King's Quest games. I know they came out with a Chapter 2, Chapter 3. If it's not out yet, it's got to be pretty soon. I still haven't finished Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2, I haven't played. So I need to finish that. So Enderal in the middle of all that. And, games coming out in the meantime. Well, Walking Dead Season 3 I can just stick in the middle, because that'll be, you know, once every 2 months I'll put out 4 or 5 episodes and then wait for the next one. So that's coming out. Torment Tides of Numenera is coming out at the, I forget what it is, the end of this year or the beginning of next year. I don't know where I'm going to fit that in. This is a long-ass game. And Mass Effect Andromeda. Now, Mass Effect Andromeda is going to be on my, you know, my tier A. So you got A and B, and A has been Mass Effect. And we'll continue to be Mass Effect. We'll see what I can squeeze in between Mass Effect 3 and before Andromeda comes out. Because I might have a month or so before that's done, maybe. And who knows, they might be delayed, you know, more, which allows me to throw more games in the middle of that. So, and after I finish playing Mass Effect Andromeda, Tier 1 will consist of the Witcher games, 1, 2, 3, all in order with all DLCs and all that fun stuff. And the way I like to do it, you know, completely 100% explored, all quests possible, and all weapons possible found, and all that fun stuff. And, 1 and 2 are not that bad, but I think you can easily spend over 100 hours, or way over 100 hours in The Witcher 3. So Tier 1 is set, except for whatever I might sneak in. Whatever shorter kind of game I might sneak in before Andromeda. Tier 2, like I said, is going to consist of, well, Star Trek, Batman episodes as they come out, Walking Dead Season 3 episodes as they come out, King's Quest, Chapter 2, maybe 3, Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2, and try to fit in Torment Tides of Numenera at some point. So, yeah, third world problems. Just too many games, not enough time to play them. If I was able to do this full time, I could definitely play all four games at once. Mass Effect series, No Man's Sky, Enderal, and the various shorter games that I have on my list, you know, of B-roll games. Just, I can't fit it. I don't know how to fit it. So, that's about it. There's not much else going on with me. I'm just I'm basically working. I'm doing well at work, so somebody told me me and one other person saved the shift, pretty much. So it's pretty interesting. So yeah, I'm not going to get into what I do. So at least not in this video. And other than that, yeah, summer is ending. September, as I'm recording this, so September is in 2 days. Can you believe that? So I'm kind of like, I'm already dreading the winter. Because New York, we typically have a mild winter and then a crazy, insane winter. Mild, insane. And basically, however crazy the summer is, that's the one that gets the bad winter. So I have a bad winter coming up. And dreading the cold and all that. But looking forward to this heat, this humidity, which is insane lately, going away. Looking forward to that. I watch hardly any TV. The shows I do watch, I really enjoy and you know, pay a lot of attention to thoughtful things. I watch The Walking Dead and Fear the Walking Dead, and I watch Game of Thrones, and I watched Preacher, which is going to be renewed for a second season. Interesting, because I actually read the story, you know, way back, graphic novels. I don't know what happened to those. I think I lost them in a move long, long ago. About 9-10 years ago. That was probably around when I lost them. Along with my 45s. I had a whole stack of 45 singles. Those are gone too. So other than that, I mean, they would have been lost now anyway, because I lost just about everything in my move 2 years ago, for anyone who may or may not be aware of that. If you look in the miscellaneous section, there's a video of me playing Skyrim, and it was about 2 years ago. So we're talking 2014, summer, and I don't know what it was. Probably June, July, something like that. Pretty tumultuous time in my life, and everything. I'm still really getting everything together that I need. Little things here and there, like I want to hammer a picture frame into the wall, and I don't have a hammer. Like, okay, gotta go get a hammer. Things like that. You know, and building up my wardrobe again and everything. So it's pretty much come together. And other than that, I'm kind of looking forward to the fall weather, but anything past Halloween is just like, please no. Please don't come. So that's about it, and I want to thank you for watching. And stay tuned for that other video where I'm going to talk about what my plans for 3,000 subscriber special are. It's nothing surprising. So thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, go strong.